one of those ADM cars.
Southern Pacific. It's a coal train. I like the commentary.
Thank you.
So the hotel.
There are two Union Pacific engines on the back end. A fine example of more cars sitting there. You know what else is moving right now?
Okay. Yeah. Yep. 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 Okay. All right. Take care of little Leon today.
Yes, one Union Pacific engine. He split his train. See that?
You're eligible if you're illegal for a waiver. But if you're a U.S. citizen, it's a felony punishable up to 3 years. If you knowingly alter a Social Security card, you're eligible for a waiver if you're here illegally. If you're a citizen, you're punishable up to 5 years. If you use document fraud to prove eligibility for employment, if you're illegal, you get a waiver under this bill. If you're a U.S. citizen, felony punishable by up to 15 years imprisonment. Failed to pay your taxes by file a return, keep required records, or supply required information. If you're illegal, you're eligible for a waiver.
I just want to know that, make sure that if we're going to, as America, the, one of the greatest nations, most generous nations on the planet, wants to help others, are we also going to help Americans who are already playing into the system and paying these pains that are out there right
one
now?
One of the problems is what the CBO report said yesterday. By the way, they're only saying that we're going to stop 25% of illegal immigration. So under the current bill, as it was recently scored, it's not going to do what they say they're going to do, and the costs are going to be high, and they even acknowledge that it's going to hurt the employment situation. We're going to have rising unemployment as a result of all this.
Well, it's great to live in this nation, but if they're not going to help us, why would not necessarily should help others, but let's start at home.
Well, maybe by the year 2025, we might see an upside in terms of Obamacare costs, they said. maybe by the year 2025. Pittsburgh, PA, WPGB, Rose Tenant Land, as we say hi to Tina. What's up, Tina?
And a 26-year-old man has been sentenced today to serve more than 11 years in prison for shipping meth from Orange County, California to Utah. Officers seizing 56 pounds of meth from Brazil as PCA's vehicle. In 2012, the drugs had a street value between $4 and $6 million. It's the largest meth bust in Utah's history. And two people died in a Wayne County crash. The accident happened near Big Mud on State Road 84. The crash remains under investigation. News, traffic, and weather will find it anytime at KNOS.com.
Summer's here, but deals are hot and getting hotter.
Get up there. Get up there. Get up there. Get up there. Yeah.